Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain checking of periodicity. Now see, in previous session, we have discussed about periodic and aperiodic signal. And at last of that session, I have told when you add two signals, when you add two periodic signal, those two, that addition may result into periodic or aperiodic signal. So here in this session, we'll be checking whether two algebraic addition signal results into periodic signal or aperiodic signal. So to check it, there are basically two methods. One method is ratio method and second method is GCD method. So here in ratio method, what we do is we will be adding two signals. So if I say one signal is x of 1 and second signal is x of 2 with period t1 and t2, and when they are summed, resultant signal is periodic in case of time period ratio t1 by t2 is rational number. So if that ratio of time period t1 and t2 is resulting into rational number, in that case one can say resultant of x1 and x2 is periodic. And second method is GCD method, where if GCD of frequency is possible, then one can say signal is periodic signal. GCD means what? GCD means when you divide two frequencies with remainder is equals to zero, in that case one can say GCD is possible and that results into given signal is periodic. So we will be doing example to understand how we can identify resultant of two signal is periodic or not. So let us have one example first, so it will be more clear. So to check periodicity, first I'll be considering one example where if x of t, that is cos of phi t plus sine of pi t. So here we have two signals, one is cos of pi t and second is sine of cos of phi t and second is sine of pi t. So when you add these two signal, let us check whether this resultant is periodic or not. So for that, cos of phi t, that is having angular frequency omega 1, if I say, so that is phi. And for second signal, sine of pi t, angular frequency is omega 2, that is pi. This is there in terms of radian per second. And from that, we can calculate time period t1. So that is 2 pi by omega 1. Omega 1 is phi, so 2 pi by phi. And time period t2 based on omega 2. So that will be t2, that is 2 pi by omega 2. Omega 2 is pi, so 2 pi by pi, so that is 2. So as if you do ratio of t1 by t2, so t1 divided by t2, so t1 is 2 pi by pi and t2 is 2, so that is resulting into pi by pi. So if you observe this pi by pi, that is not a rational number. It is not a rational number. So as this is not a rational number, one can say this signal this is aperiodic signal. So this is how we can identify this given resultant signal of two periodic signal is periodic or not. And by using GCD method even, we can identify whether given signal is periodic or not. So for that, what we can do is, like, see, we have omega 1, that is phi, and omega 2, that is pi. So if you do omega 1 divided by omega 2, there will be somewhat remainder. So as there is remainder, one can say GCD is not possible. And as GCD is not possible, we can say given signal is aperiodic signal. So here, based on second method, GCD is not possible. So given signal is aperiodic signal. Let us have few more examples so it will be more clear. So I am considering second example where x of t, that is cos of pi t plus sine of 4 pi t. So based on this, if we can calculate omega 1, that is pi, and based on sine 4 pi t, we can have omega 2, that is 4 pi. And from this, we can have t1, that is 2 pi by omega 1. So that is 2 pi by pi. So that is 2. And we can have t2. So that is 2 pi by omega 2. Omega 2 is 4 pi. So this is half. So if we calculate ratio t1 by t2, so that is 2 divided by half. So this 2 will go in numerator. So 2 into 2, 4. So this is rational number. It is rational number. Rational means 4 by 1. That is what rational number, or one can say integer number. So as it is integer or rational number, we can say this is periodic signal. So this is periodic signal. Now based on GCD, we can even calculate, like, see, if you do omega 2 by omega 1, so that will be 4 with remainder is equals to 0. So GCD is possible. If you do this calculation, see, omega 2 divided by omega 1, so there is no remainder. It will be having value that is 4 without any remainder. So GCD is possible. And as GCD is possible, we can say given signal is periodic signal. So here GCD of two signal is possible. So given signal is periodic signal. So that is how we can identify whether given signal is periodic or not. Let us have one more case so it will be more clear. Now see, I'll be going to consider one more case, that is x of t, that is cos pi t plus cos 3 pi t plus sine 5 pi t. So here I am adding three signals. So from this, we can have three angular frequency, omega 1, that is pi, omega 2, based on cos 3 pi t, we have omega 2 is equals to 3 pi, and based on sine 5 pi t, we have omega 3, that is 5 pi. So based on that, we can have t1, that is omega 1, sorry, 2 pi by omega 1. So that is 2 pi by pi, that is 2. Omega 2 results into t2, that is 2 pi by omega 2. So 2 pi by 3 pi, so that is 3 by 2. And based on omega 3, we can have t3, that is 2 pi by omega 3. 2 pi by 5 pi, so that is 2 by 5. So now we have t1, t2 and t3. So here we can have ratio, we need to identify whether t1, t2 and t3 is rational or not. So if you do this, t1 gem t2 gem t3, so that is actually 2 gem 3 by 2 gem 2 by 5. And if you take LCM of this, you will be having, this is 2 and 5, LCM will be 10. So that is what over here. So that is 20 gem. Over here it will be 15 gem. Over here it will be 2 into 2, 4. So this is what rational number. One can see this is rational number. T1, gem T2, gem T3, that is rational number here. So we can say this given signal is periodic signal. So given signal is periodic signal. I hope that you have understood this session. So basically, whenever you have multiple addition of periodic signal, we need to identify that a time period here should be rational number. The time period here ratio, that should be rational number. And if it is rational number, in that case, we can say that given signal is periodic signal. So there are two ways by which we can identify whether that resultant is periodic or not. One is rational ratio method and second is GCD method. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will be solving your queries. So please give your suggestions. I'm waiting for your suggestions. I'm watching all those suggestions that you are writing in comments. And in future, you are getting those videos which were there based on your suggestions. Thank you so much for watching this video.